Even today, in the old city of Jerusalem, you can visit the Church of the Holy Sepulchre, which is the shrine of the burial place of Jesus. This site has been rebuilt many times through the centuries, and now it is beyond recognition as a garden in which there was a new tomb. What remains of the burial cave has been now protected by layers of marble, but yet you can stand in this tiny chamber and you can see for yourself what the gospel proclaims. The body of Jesus is not here. Now, skeptics would dismiss all that and say, well, it's just made up. It's something people built as a monument, and that no one really knows where or even if the body of Jesus was buried. You can visit the sepulcher and you can walk away confused, unconvinced, or you can believe. What is beyond doubt is that something happened in that place. Something happened near the city of Jerusalem nearly 2,000 years ago. Something unexplainable and yet very real. What happened was that people's lives were changed because of Jesus Christ. They've read his words, they've heard his story, but more importantly, they have encountered him, not as a dead man, but as one living, not someone from long ago, but someone present to us, the living Christ who shares life with us as our teacher, our brother, our friend. In the gospel today, one of the important characters is Mary Magdalene, the first witness to the resurrection. In the recent video series, The Chosen, Mary Magdalene is portrayed as a woman in deep pain, one whose life has been so difficult for her, she's ready to give up. It's suggested that she is a victim of abuse, and her sense of herself has been shattered, so much so that she has taken on a nickname, which means that she is simply evil. But one day, as the portrayal goes on, Mary meets a mysterious stranger who seems to know all about her. He calls her by her proper name. He recites to her some words of scripture, which, when Mary was a little child, were often read to her by her father to comfort her in her fears. This mysterious man gently takes her head into his hands, silently prays, and Mary is completely healed. She's liberated from her tormented past. She's free from any trace of evil. And as the story continues to unfold some days later, Mary is asked how it happened and who this man was. She says, "I don't understand it myself, but here is what I can tell you. Before, I was one way. Now I am completely different. And the thing that happened in between was him. So yes, I will know him the rest of my life." This dramatization was composed so that we might get to know Mary a little bit more as a real person. But the real desire of the screenwriter was that Jesus Christ might be for us a real person. And though we may have not had such a dramatic or powerful, miraculous experience as Mary did, if we are growing in our faith, we also can notice the times when we have met the Lord, that he has called us by name, and that he has done wonderful things for us. The Apostle Paul, in his writing to us today, calls this being raised up with Christ. He says, "You have died, and your life is hidden with Christ in God." And so every Sunday we come together to eat and drink with him who is risen from the dead. And we affirm for ourselves the words of the prophets and the apostles that in his name we have found forgiveness. The powerful words of Jesus in his own time drew thousands of people to come and hear him. And Jesus still speaks to us. We can read his words for ourselves in the Gospels. We hear them read aloud to us in church. And in moments of quiet prayer, as we invoke the Holy Spirit, we can still hear Jesus call us by name and show us how those ancient words, those old stories, are fresh and new for us and still speak to us today. Jesus' miraculous deeds, in our experience, are the sacraments. For he is and always will be present and active through them. Jesus continues to heal and to forgive. He continues to strengthen our marriages and build up our communities. He still calls us each by name. The evidence is no longer about an empty grave, a tomb, a stone. The evidence of the risen Christ is in the people who he has encountered, people who have come to faith in him and who know the power of the resurrection in their own lives. They can say with Mary Magdalene, "I can't explain it. I just know I was one way, and now I am different, and the difference is him." Easter is the day the Lord has made, and we rejoice in it. Easter is also the way the Lord has made, and we follow him.